Part four. I forgot about balancing. Dr. Phil calls it balancing. This is when Cindy says, you know, here George is talking about that he gambled away $30,000, which I do not believe. I think it's sitting in a savings account under his mother's maiden name. But in it's his savings account. Anyway, he's gone ahead and gambled away all their savings. But Cindy jumps in there and says, but he was under so much stress. I was with him. I was with him doing, he went through 6 months of hell. And those 6 months, incidentally, were spent hustling a young woman that, Crystal, you know, River Cruz, who was brave enough to step forward, and that she made a, you know, it's so humiliating to be taken advantage of by a cad. And she is, and anyway, he's having an affair during this 6 months that he's supposed to be going through absolute hell. He's having an affair, and he's over to her house most every day, except probably when Cindy is home. And yet when Dr. Phil says, but here's Casey, and she's probably stolen around $300-$400 from her, and Cindy doesn't forgive her. He says, would you forgive her? I don't think I can. I can't forgive her. But she makes excuses for George, but not for Casey. And this is the way it's been. This is what Casey has been living with all of her life, is her mother bending over backwards to excuse George because she doesn't have the wherewithal to get rid of him or to call him on his stuff. And here he's going and killing her children and grandchild, and she's still backing him. So that's a big red flag. The other big red flag is the refusal to submit to lie detector tests. This means they even hauled in Lee. Any relative that refuses to take a poly is really weird. I mean, they're usually the ones that just, take anything you want, you know. And anything to help find Kaylee. But not this bunch. No, that means they did a felony of some sort, and they're guilty of something. And here is Lee. He supposedly hasn't done anything, but he should have said, you know, yeah, to their request for a poly. Now we're always going to wonder just what Lee did that warranted him refusing a polygraph. Let's see. Is there anything? Oh, George knew that the car had sat in Amscot 3 days before it was towed. How did he know that? I'm going through there, see if I've got anything else. They got the wrong car. And Cindy went to, she's got those foundation funds on the mind, I think. She's money, money, money. That's all for now. Talk to you later.